American Horror Story Double Feature is finally coming to our screens in about a week and a half, and FX has just released the full trailer for part one of the season, which has the subtitle of Red Tide. Like usual, details about this season of AHS have been very secretive, and even with the new light that the trailer does shed on it, there's still a lot we don't know about these chilling occurrences in Provincetown. So today I'm going to dissect and squeeze out all of the info that I can get from this trailer, but before I do, let me take this moment to recognize my channel members. As always, thank you guys so much for your support and for making these videos possible. It means the world to me. Alright, let's just jump into the breakdown. The trailer begins. The trailer begins and we are introduced to Harry, played by Finn Wittrock, Doris, played by Lily Rabe, and their daughter, who is rumored to be named Alma, played by Ryan Kiara Armstrong. This character has had a lot of rumored names over the past few months, so take Alma with a grain of salt. Doris is very pregnant, and they say that they have just moved to Provincetown. Harry is a writer, and one of the reasons for the move seems to be that Harry is experiencing writer's block. We then see Harry befriending Austin, played by Evan Peters, the chemist, played by Angelica Ross, and Francis Conroy's character, who is rumored to be named Belle. But take that name with a grain of salt as well. These three assure Harry that they have a solution to Harry's writer's block, and we find out that Austin is also a writer. They then raise their glasses, leading me to think that the solution to the problem may be a secret ingredient in these cocktails. But more on that later. Harry is then shown filling up his previously blank Word document, so it seems as though whatever Austin, Belle, and the chemist did worked. Side note, we can also confirm that this portion of the season does take place in the present day, as Harry is using a recent iPhone model and a recent computer. Then we see a shot of a character who I'm assuming is Alma, but we only see the back of her, so who knows, but she is crying over a tombstone that says Brandon Newman, deceased on the 10th of January, 1775, a fine soldier, aged 26 years. A brief Google search didn't find any exact matches for this name in that time period, so this doesn't seem to be any reference to a real soldier, as far as I can tell. However, I do think this may be a hint towards a subplot taking place in or around the time of the Revolutionary War, but who knows what connection Alma may have with the fallen soldier, but I'm intrigued. Next, we get our first look at Macaulay Culkin's character, who is rumored to go by the name Mickey. Ursula, played by Leslie Grossman, is shown expressing some vague suspicions about the town to Mickey. We already assumed that these two characters were linked based on a photo that Ryan shared on social media earlier this year, and this is further confirmation that Ursula and Mickey are working together. Belle says, "There is nothing more addictive than success. You've tasted it now, and you're never going to live without it." Presumably, she is saying this to Harry, although we don't know that for sure. We then see Doris cutting her finger while she is chopping up some vegetables, and the sight of her blood definitely seems to ignite something in Harry. That shot is followed by Belle and Austin in the front seat of a car pointing a gun at Harry, who is in the back seat. It seems like Harry may be in over his head getting involved with the Provincetown locals, and there is definitely an organized crime vibe coming from Belle and Austin. Next, we see the chemist in her laboratory where she crafts a black capsule, just like the ones we previously saw in the teaser for the season. These pills are also featured in some posters we've gotten for Double Feature, and she seems to be making quite a lot of these black pills. We then see Sarah Paulson as TB Karen reacting in fear to something off-screen, followed by a shot of Harry looking a bit deranged as he manically types away at his computer. Doris says, "We are not safe here," and descends the staircase with a knife in hand. We then see one of the creatures, who may or may not be sirens, breaking through a window. This is intercut with shots of Doris opening a door in her house and reacting in shock, although I think it's pretty clear that the window breaking and Doris opening the door are two different scenes, and Doris is reacting to something else entirely in the scene. Kinda seems like she may be discovering a dead body in her home. I was very excited to see a shot of Dennis O'Hare's character in the season, whose name we have yet to learn, but his character is seen walking his dogs along the beach, when he finds a severed hand and a foot on the shore. The hand has a very prominent ring with the letter R on it, but none of these characters that we know of so far have an R initial in their name. So I can't make any guesses on who the hand belongs to, but I will say this is very similar to how the body of the Lady of the Dunes was discovered. Although I'm pretty certain that this season has enough going on in it, they don't need to bring this cold case into the mix. But again, who knows? I did do a video on the Lady of the Dunes if you haven't seen it already. But anyway, Alma then states, "It takes pain to make beautiful things," followed by some shots of her being very proficient at playing the violin. I wonder if she is also being slipped some performance-enhancing substances from the locals. Mickey is then shown walking through a house holding a crowbar, followed by our only shot of Adina Porter in the trailer, and goddamn, spoiler alert, but her neck is gushing with blood. You know, it's hard to come back from a slit in the throat, so I fear that this is her death scene. We know Adina is playing a police chief named Chief Burleson, and she is wearing her uniform in this shot from what may be her death scene. But who knows, maybe there is more to the scene, as this is a pretty big spoiler for the trailer to hit us with, if this is the end of Chief Burleson. I'm gonna talk a little bit more about Adina later, but let's move on. We then see Belle pulling out a switchblade and swinging it at somebody off-screen, with Austin and Harry by her side. Cut to a shot of Harry in a basement kneeling over a body he's presumably killed, and then he appears to shoot an off-screen witness as well. Harry says, "I'm trying to keep this family together under very difficult circumstances." Then Billie Lord makes her appearance as Lark, who is firing up a dental drill and taking it to Harry's teeth. It seems as though the body modification hints and theories are referring to this character. She barely shows up in this trailer, so I'm pretty intrigued to find out more information about Lark come August 25th. Next, TB Karen is seen feeding off of Mickey's neck. I don't know, maybe it's just an intense hug, but with the following shot of Karen with blood dripping from her mouth, I'm going to go with this is Karen indicating some vampiric tendencies. Next, there is a peculiar shot of one of the creatures who may or may not be sirens, but they look more like Nosferatu. In this shot, the creature is holding flowers at the cemetery as someone falls to her knees before it. We can't really see the character that is falling to her knees, but I'm gonna take a wild guess and say it might be Lark. Then the final shot of the trailer is Doris screaming in the pain of labor with Harry by her side. We then get a list of the 10 main cast members for Red Tide, which is 80% identical to the one we got way back in the beginning of 2020, which honestly is pretty impressive considering all that has transpired since then. But as we've long suspected, Kathy Bates is no longer a part of the cast. The other cast member that is missing from this list that was in the first cast announcement is Adina Porter. Now, there is a lot this could mean, and obviously Adina is in the season, but firstly, due to something in Adina's contract in regards to her commitments to other shows, in the past and previous seasons, she hasn't been credited as a main, despite being one of the season's main characters. This was the case for Lee Harris in Roanoke and Beverly Hope in Colt, so it very well could be another contractual conflict at play here that means she can't be credited as a main cast member and her character still could be a main character. Or maybe her role has changed a lot in the year and a half since the first cast was announced. Her character's death was potentially just spoiled by the trailer, so maybe she really isn't a pivotal character this year, but only time will tell. So while the second cast list lacks Kathy and Adina, it does have two cast members that were not in the first cast announcement, with Frances Conroy and Ryan Kiera Armstrong, but we've long known that they are a part of the season as well. Okay, now that we've run down the basic premise and the events that we see transpire in the trailer, let's do some theorizing. The first thing I want to talk about is the undeniable vampire vibes of this trailer. I mean, with TB Karen literally feeding from somebody's neck, and then this shot of Harry looking at Doris's bloody finger, I think perhaps one of the side effects of the drug that Harry is taking is a thirst for blood. Presumably, the chemist is behind this drug, and I wonder if she is using people in the town to test some of her drugs. Maybe TB Karen was a part of an earlier trial of this drug, and the drug that Harry is taking is more effective, as the drug seems to affect creativity and productivity, because Harry's writer's block is cured, and he even seemingly finds success in his writing based on what Belle implies. But like Belle says, success can be addictive. If Belle and Austin are also taking the same drug as Harry, they are definitely more high-functioning than TB Karen and the deranged Harry that we see glimpses of in the trailer. Maybe the difference is dosage, or maybe Belle and Austin aren't taking the drug and they're just working for the chemist to loop people into her medical trials. I don't know, but I don't think these people are literal vampires like the ones we've seen in Hotel, but more like chemically made vampires at the hands of the chemist. I'm definitely thinking Harry will struggle with a thirst for blood this season, and perhaps that is why he goes to Lark to sharpen his teeth. Maybe this is a common service that Lark provides to the people of Provincetown, depending on how widespread this operation is. Well, you guys, the wait is almost over for season 10, and let me say this season looks extremely promising based on the trailer. Visually, it looks more striking than any season since Hotel, dare I say, largely due to this Massachusetts and winter setting, but also the cinematography is looking reminiscent of Murder House or Asylum even. With that said though, it also looks like something very fresh and new for AHS. It definitely has its own look and feel, and I'm really looking forward to exploring these characters and the setting more. I've been dreaming of a snow-capped season of AHS reminiscent of The Shining for forever, and this will definitely satisfy that dream for me, I think. Especially with Harry's writer's block, I'm pretty certain that the season will be drawing some inspiration from The Shining, so that's exciting. Part of me is a little bummed that we'll only be here for part one of the season, but we still know practically nothing about part two, Death Valley, so let's not jump the gun. But there you have it. That is my breakdown of the Red Tide trailer for Double Feature. Make sure you're subscribed for more AHS content. Let me know all of your thoughts and your theories in the comments below, and I will see you guys very soon. Thank you for watching.